All right. I suppose against the reanimator deck, this is a keepable hand. Hopefully, I don't get Cabal Therapy turn one. Probably even going to, because that's how things work. Oh, well, no, or not. Ponder is more than fine. Even though Cabal Therapy really sucks for me, I think Forceful Willing a Ponder is a bit excessive. Alright, so wouldn't mind a blue card here or a Mox. Nah, no, don't really want that one. Alright, let's just play this. Pass. Okay, if my opponent has once again a reanimate plus a Cabal Therapy this turn, then I'm in trouble. Otherwise, I actually think I'm in pretty good shape since my opponent chose to shuffle too, which is a good sign. Since I do have Force of Will this turn and then Rest in Peace next turn. Okay, not Cabal Therapy just once. And Cabal Therapy. Alright, well, I'm forcing it since. Seems unlikely my opponent would not name Force of Will since my opponent named Force against Flooded Strand and has been very willing to do so. Alright, blue card. Nice. That is pretty good since having a turn two Rest in Peace seems like it messed with my opponent's game plan pretty significantly. Using last time as an example. And I still have a Force of Will back up here, which is nice. I haven't used my Delta yet because I might want to shuffle away cards with that are screen scroll wrecked here. Alright, Cabal Therapy is fine. Probably gonna hit. Let's see. What do we name? Do you name the third Force of Will? I force pitching force. That's gotta reduce your odds of naming Force of Will, right? Chosen Lightning Tutor. Haha, you did not hit this time. Well, that's a relief since even though now my opponent knows about the days and the force, can't really do much, hopefully. Alright, let's draw. That would have been, I think, better before, but I'm not gonna. Certainly not putting any of these cards under the Chrome Mox. Not yet. And I'm not cracking this Delta yet either. I'll just draw for my turn here. Draw. Ooh, land tax. Alright. Tax rack. Ready to go. My opponent's got three lands in play, so I can Stone Rain both of us. Let's see if my opponent plays a fourth land. Question is, do I want to Stone Rain both of us? Since if my opponent doesn't do anything, I can sack Delta end of turn, get no land, but that also shows my opponent that same trick. Let's Skorak for one here. Put back Chrome Mox. And I don't actually need lands here, so. Ooh, land tax has triggered. Alright, maybe my opponent didn't realize what was going on too, which is kind of sweet. I mean, little Modo shenanigans there. Don't actually need black for any reason right now. I'm just looking at my deck. Alright, good. Just gotta make sure. So I've drawn. And do I want to play a land here? Let's see, I could Skorak for a million. I think I actually do want to Skorak for a lot now. Let's see, let's put back these four cards. Alright, that is pretty sweet. And let's just play a Flooded Strand and pass. Since I would like to get more lands in play, and I can use this to just shuffle away those cards, or I can just, even if I end up cracking the fetch and not getting anything just to land tax again, I think that's okay. And this means that if my opponent does play a land, I do get to land tax here. So I don't have Counterbalance up, but I've got a lot of action in hand. Alright. Yeah. I would love to land tax here. And draw a card. Alright. Now I'm probably Chrome Moxing. Well, maybe I'll just Mox a diamond at this point. Actually, can I take them back? No, at this point it's too late once you've clicked on them. Alright. Put them back. Top of Labyrinth. Alright, well, let's play. And then let's play Counterbalance. So I guess I wish I'd kept Chrome Mox here, since then I'd be able to Chrome Mox away one of my sweet cards. I'm just discarding Entreat because I don't need to. Alright, since I've got Countermounts, I've got a 0 on top, but that doesn't mean I get to counter this Lotus Bowl for free. I was going to say I can crack Fetch in response and then cast either Brainstorm or Enlightened Tutor, but I think no matter which I do, I'm in pretty good shape here since I kind of got the full lock going. Dark Ritual. That I don't think I want to resolve, so let's. I guess I can't. Yeah, I can get either one. I'm just going to get Brainstorm here. Countering Dark Ritual for free seems nice. And let's put back an entreat and a stifle. Alright, so ones are off limits, and I have force of will for anything else. Fairly good place to be. Plus a daze, too, since I can force pitching spell pierce and then daze something. So, I'm going to have quite the combination of cards to get by, especially since the ones are the ones that are hand disruption here. So, I don't think it's going to be easy. Alright, cracking a fetch land. That is allowable. That is one of the few game actions left to my opponent that I cannot just stop. Alright, well, that I can't stop. Either, or rather, I choose not to. Since, again, my opponent can't play ones, and has got to play... And if it plays two casting cast spells, I force the first, daze the second, assuming they're both even relevant. And ditto if any more expensive spell, I can just force. So. Pretty much take that, has been called. I get to advance to 1-1, I think, here, since once I untap... I have basically all the same amount of problems, or rather the same amount of counters up that I did, except now double score rec to go with my counterbalance here, and I now have a stifle. Alright, so playing another score rec. Do I want to land tax again? Am I going to play a land, or am I going to be completely out of taxation? Let's just play this, because one of my opponent's strategies seems to be playing lands up to try to cast Gristlebrand, so I'll just not play any lands. This is not going to work, I'm afraid. Alright. I'm going to activate Skrorak. And I'm going to put back land, and again, stifle. I'm going to draw those. I'm going to put back land, stifle. And let's see what happens here. Well, I stifled my opponent's Cabal Therapy. Oh, white mana. What is going on? Serenity? Yeah, I don't want that to resolve either, so let's use Skrorak again. Let's put back land, entreat, daze. And let's put them back kind of in that reverse order. Serenity's a nice one. I mean, had it resolved, it would have been quite the problem for me. One tap, draw. I have 8 cards. Do I want to just give up on land taxing here? I could. Yeah, that seems fine. I'll start hitting land drops. Very boring, I know. And eventually I'll draw a Jace or something and then just win the game with that. I suppose with between Spell Pierce and Double Skrorak use and casting Enlightened Tutor, having mana up is not the end of the world. Alright. Do I want to shuffle? Actually, let's do a little swap here first. I'm going to swap out a swamp for a stifle. No, I'll keep the stifle for entreat. And then end of turn, Enlightened Tutor. I'm just going to pick up a Sensei's Divining Top here. Seems like the top pick. Bam. Play Sensei's Top. And now I don't have to use Skrorak to do all my counterbalance shenanigans, and this gives me a little bit more control. All right, well, my opponent is done. I cannot blame him. All right, sweet, 1-1.